What's going on, guys, and welcome back to another exciting Tech Tip Tuesday. And together we are reviewing network layouts, and let's get right into it. All right, so let's start with the modem. Now, the modem is basically a network device, but is not the start of your network. The modem actually provides the rest of the network devices within your environment internet access, and the modem is actually connected to a router or a gateway. Now, the router or the gateway is basically the heart of the network. It connects to the modem to manage incoming and outgoing internet traffic and data within your network. It connects to the rest of the network devices such as printers, computers, storage devices, and servers. It can also be wired or wirelessly. It manages devices within your local network and also monitors and manages the traffic between your local network and the internet. And last but not least, it actually provides basic security. Now, for wireless router and gateway, it broadcasts the Wi-Fi network signal throughout your office, right, or throughout your network. And this is typically done by a network name or a SSID, which stands for Service Set Identifier. And typically, this Wi-Fi hotspot or this SSID has a password. Hopefully, you have a password. And it gives you access to your network once you log into your Wi-Fi. Wireless routers and gateways also have Ethernet ports behind it to give wired connections to, you know, servers, storage devices, printers, or even desktop computers. We also have switches, and it adds more wired connections to your network. Basically, a Cat5 cable connects each network device to a switch. And then one cable from the switch actually provides uplink connectivity to a router and the gateway to provide more access to the other ports on that switch. Now, for network layout and troubleshooting, the modem affects the internet access, all right, but not the local access. So if the modem goes down, you're still able to access all your printers and your file share. Now, if the router goes down, it affects the entire network. That means you're not able to access your file share, printers, or the internet. Now, if a switch goes down, does not mean it will go down for everyone. It will only affect those computers that are connected to that switch. And then last but not least, one computer off the network doesn't affect the rest of the network. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Do not forget about smashing that subscribe button. And also hit that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next Tech Tip Tuesday. Peace out.